So the family themselves, as we see, they bought the builder's yard off the Grimshaws. Already upset Ken with the noise
Ken
and the damage.
One, do you?
I know.
Thinking.
Let's start. Let's find out who they all are first of all. Then in that case, so with Trevor, who plays Edison, you say as an actor, this is a dream you never thought you could have.
Oh God, unbelievable! We were in total shock when my agent phoned and said they want to see you at Corrie, and I thought you put me up for Corrie, and he went no. And I said, I'm really, really confused. And I've been confused ever since.
they came to you.
Yeah.
Which is fantastic. I mean, we've all done a lot of work elsewhere. So who is Edison? How would you describe him?
Edison's a man's man who's made his way as a builder and as a property developer, and a man who's very good at wheeling dealing in certain ways, but for reasons that will...
Well, he's not without his secrets, is he?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
So there's a lot more to come from him, for sure.
How does it feel working with Bill Roach?
Surreal. Yeah, I can't put it any other way. To walk into the Rovers is a shock enough. And yeah, there's Bill standing going, hi, how are you doing? And I don't know.
Just stepped into my TV.
Speechless.
So Lorna, you play Aggie. She's the mum of the family. This must be a bit of a dream for you also, because Coronation Street is something that you've had in your life before you were even part of it.
We grew up watching Coronation Street. Yeah. So it's a massive, massive thing. And it's that amazing thing when you've been working in theatre for a long time. And I know I did Doctors, but it's your family don't quite know what you do. Till you're on telly, they don't quite know what you do.
And
do
now
you know
they clearly all
now
do.
They clearly know, all of them. Even people who aren't related. Well done, sis.
But you've got a Brummie accent.
I've got my Brummie. I am.
So how's the Northern accent? Because in Doctors, you had to have a Botswana accent.
I had a Botswana accent. And all through those first scenes, all I kept going was, do not go to your default. Do not go to default Botswana. You've got to stay Northern. It was really difficult. It was your mouth is so trained to do an accent and actually get in your head with this new character and make her really believable and really give an impact. It was really quite difficult.
Yeah, I bet. Well, then we've got Nathan. So, Nathan, you are the... play James. He's the youngest son of the family. Although you're not the youngest actor in the family.
No.
So he's meant to be 19. How old are you?
28.
Oh! Listen, this is great. Trust me. When you get older, you're going to be loving the fact that
you still get asked for ID?
Sometimes, yeah.
Do you?
Well, maybe now. I might not hope.
So who is he? What's his story?
He's a youth footballer at Weatherfield County. He's gay. On a Aggie, mum knows about it. So he's got that whole journey to, you know, the rest of the family and his teammates sort of finding out and how they deal with that, I don't know. But within himself, he knows that he is gay and he's comfortable with that. I think it's just the fear of, you know, the unknown of coming out and what response he might get to it. And
well, it does eventually. This leads to a sort of homophobic storyline, doesn't it?
Because not only is he gay, but, I mean, he's black and gay and in football as well, like you've seen.
Yeah.
There's still a lot of racism that goes on, so it's kind of like a double whammy for him in a way.
And then we've got Ryan, who's Michael, and so he's one of those guys. He seems to be one of those guys that might be sort of in for the cheap buck, you know, in for the easy deal. Is that how would you
a lot of get rich quick schemes? Like Alan, not sugar, Alan Sweetener, and he's a bit like he wants to be successful, but he's not sure where he can find his success from, and a lot of fingers in lots of pies.
Well, is he going to be successful with Michelle? Because there's always that love is on the cards. Yeah. He's trying.
He's a fighter.
Eamonn, she's leaving though, isn't she?
Yes, she is.
So there's no luck there, mate.
Well, it might be my fault. Right?
I don't know.
Nothing to do with your character.
We'll see.
There is another member of the family to arrive as well, isn't there?
Yeah, a daughter.
Yes. And so this is Diane, isn't it?
Yeah.
And is it you that's quite close to the
Yeah, I think we all are as a family, but Michael and Dee Dee, they have some sort of similar sibling rivalry.
Yeah.
So there's a quite a bit of not tension, but there's a love there, but there's a bit of competition.
Yeah. And obviously, you know, there'll be people watching this going, hang on a minute, you're on CBeebies. So you've kind of left all of that side. Yeah. So this must feel totally different.
Yeah, I can't look down the barrel anymore, straight down the camera. Yeah. Watching yeah, yeah. But yeah.
And the clothes don't have to be quite so bright.
No, not as well. Well, Michael's wearing a lot of bright clothes, but I don't have to dress up like a Viking princess or a carrot.
I wouldn't pay money to see that.
it's good. But I love my time at CBeebies, but I'm excited for the...
It's funny, actually, because both Holly and I, we both, when we wrote our interviews this morning, both of us had, like, as the absolute last question, because, you know, it seems like it shouldn't even really be a thing anymore. That the fact this is the first black family on Coronation Street. But, you know, is that even a question?
It's a question that we've all been asked every single time, and everybody's still shocked that we're having to answer it.
Yeah.
I think it's incredible that we're still discussing this. We're still looking at a whole black family is making news across the water, and it's big news. It's not like little news. I mean, we were in... my family called me from New York to say, you're in the New York Times. And I go, are you serious? So it's a massive thing. The show's been going for 60 years, and as a whole family, there's never been a whole family with
children. But it's interesting, because I think a lot of people on the Corrie team, when you guys came in, because it's, you know, it's a brand new family, it's fantastic, went, oh, haven't we? They didn't even realise themselves.
Well, in fairness to ITV, there have been black scenarios. Yeah. I think it was 1961. For three episodes, they had a family in there, which is hardly establishing it. And of course, Craig and others have been passing through. But this whole sort of new presentation of a family on the street.
Well, long may they remain, quite frankly. We'll see where the Baileys go. And it's lovely having you all here today
and
enjoy it as well.
Good luck, guys. Nice to see you.